morning, good afternoon, or good evening. I'm Audrey Wiggins, and welcome to another webisode of Make Something Happen. I'm excited to be here today with Cheryl Smith. She drove quite a few miles to be with us today. She's going to be sharing with us today about her company called Collaboration Station. It's a nonprofit. You're the CEO, you're the director. Cheryl, give us a little more information.
Sure. Well, Collaboration Station is a 501c3, and what we do primarily is assist individuals who want to start their own nonprofit or for-profit businesses.
All right.
And we do a lot of things that assist individuals that are a little bit different than what they normally would see in their typical small business development center.
Okay.
And I'll talk a little bit more about some of those things. But primarily, the people that come to us are very passionate people. Mm-hmm. And they're either passionate about trying to increase their income or getting a supplemental income, or they're passionate about doing something to help their community, and they want to know, how do I do this? How do I start a nonprofit of my own? Do I have to?
Okay.
Can I just do a community project? And how would I go about doing that?
Okay.
So we give them all the coaching and ins and outs of those two things to help them be able to build up themselves, their families, and their community.
That's awesome. Well, we'll hear more from Cheryl, and we'll be right back after this message.
Hi, I'm Dr. Howard Cohn, and I'm here to tell you about the key to alkalizing your body, and that's our 7.2 greens. This product is amazing. You'll never find anything else like it on the market. This thing has taken so much time to put together to get it exactly the way we want it, so that you can literally eat it out of your hand, out of the container. Most people know that if they eat greens, they're going to be healthier. They start doing it, they do it for a day or two, they try wheatgrass or they try eating spinach or broccoli, and they go, you know what, I can't do this. It tastes like I'm licking the bottom of my lawnmower. And they stop. They know it's good, but they stop and they don't do it. We've engineered these greens to taste amazing. I can't wait for you to try them. Our 7.2 greens are made with all organic ingredients, certified organic ingredients. Our cereal grasses, which are barley grass, oat grass, alfalfa, and wheatgrass, all organic. Our alkalizing vegetables of parsley, broccoli, broccoli sprouts, spinach, kale, cabbage, carrot, and more, all organic. Our flavoring, which is apple and raspberry, organic. And even our Lohan berry, all natural sweetener. No allergies, no soy fillers, no artificial flavors, no colors, no sweeteners. There is nothing on the market like this. I've tried literally hundreds of greens products, all a disappointment. I've had tons of patients say they can't do it. For the first time ever, we have a greens product that people will not only take, but they'll love. I can't wait for you to try it.
We're back now with Cheryl Smith from Collaboration Station. Cheryl, you gave us a brief synopsis of what Collaboration Station does, what it stands for. Let's get into a little more meat of that, and also how you got involved in that area in the first place.
Okay. Well, I am a founder CEO.
Okay.
And awesome. So Collaboration Station has been in business for 8 years now.
Congratulations.
Thank you. It's been a hard road, but a good road.
Oh, yes.
Good road. And so we're able to really give entrepreneurs, individuals, a perspective of, okay, realistically, if you want to start a business, this is the road that you're about to embark upon. Mm-hmm. By being a founder CEO, I'm able to help people better understand that.
That's
emotional,
right.
Mental, as well as professional commitment. Mm-hmm. We initially started in Columbus, Ohio.
Okay.
And then I moved to Cleveland, Ohio, in about, I think it was 2005.
Okay.
And decided to get a little bit of understanding of the lay of the land of Northeast Ohio before I re-energized Collaboration Station, which is in Northeast Ohio. It's a lot different from Central Ohio.
That's right.
But the need was great here. So Collaboration Station really got reinvigorated at the request of individuals who knew that we assisted people who wanted to start and build their nonprofit organization, but needed additional coaching.
Okay.
And that's really the hallmark of what we do. One of the things that makes us a little bit different from most individuals or most agencies that do entrepreneurship training is that we focus on the coaching side. And we do that for a couple of reasons.
All right.
One is individuals like to have attention.
Yes, that's important. We can't get away from that. I'm sorry.
I'm Absolutely.
Yes.
And when you are building a new venture, it is important that you have that one-on-one technical assistance and expertise so that you can make the best decision not only for your business, but for you as an entrepreneur in terms of how you're going to go about building it.
Right.
And coaching is, and business professional coaching is the industry that we're in, is a very good way to do that. Mm-hmm. So every other program that we offer to entrepreneurs stems off of that one-on-one relationship.
Okay.
We also include group relationships where they have, where we have other entrepreneurs who have been out there, who have started their for-profit or their nonprofit and come in and give expertise in a seminar fashion to small groups that we serve.
Okay.
And so that's one of the things that we add on to the coaching, the mentor aspect and training aspect through other small business entrepreneurs. We started getting for-profit entrepreneurs with individuals who have particular social barriers to their success entrepreneurship-wise, which is another thing that makes us different from typical entrepreneurship programs.
What are some of those barriers?
Well, some of the barriers is with a lot of the individuals that we serve on that side, they're ex-offenders.
Okay.
They're people in addiction recovery. Mm-hmm. They could be seniors on a fixed income, and we get a lot of single parents.
Okay.
And so trying to navigate life and your lifestyle as you know it now and do something to help yourself through entrepreneurship may take a little bit more than, let's say, for example, trying to get a loan. I may not qualify for that based on my history.
Yes.
So can I still make this business happen? Absolutely. You most certainly can.
Okay.
And so what we do is we encourage people but also give them real practical tips and the realism around starting a business, and then the practical tips come into the coaching with, okay, well, here's where you are.
Okay.
This is where you want to be.
Yes.
So here's the strategy that we're going to put together to get you there in spite of what you have been through. Because you have a very good learning experience from what you've been through, good or bad.
That's right. That's right.
And you can apply that to your moving forward and making sure you take that forward step, taking your business from an idea to an actual working business, shingle out, individual, serving customers.
Mm-hmm.
And that's really what people really want to do. A lot of times, the individuals that we serve who have those social barriers are really trying to make an extra income for themselves.
Okay.
Public assistance is not enough.
That's
right. You know, and it's not designed to be.
Yeah, and you can't. Exactly. You can't go from here.
Exactly.
That's right. That's right. It's a temporary situation.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. So we show them, okay, well, within those confines, here's how, here's the direction and the strategy you should put in place to now begin to build for yourself an income. And the same thing is true for individuals who want to start a nonprofit.
Okay.
Sometimes it's assumed that individuals who may come from those kinds of social barriers, whether it's the addiction recovery or ex-offenders, don't want to give back, but a lot of them do.
Absolutely. They
really do.
They have a lot of expertise in that area. Exactly. They can train and motivate. Yes.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. And so then we have the conversation about them doing a nonprofit or community activity that will help them give back to the community and help someone not go down the same road that they went down.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a lot of fun, but it's also a lot of work.
Okay.
We always tease our clients about entrepreneurs constantly have homework.
Yes. we can't get away from it. It's like home is the work.
Exactly. And so it's a significant learning curve, which is the other thing that makes us different. We cater to everyone's learning curve and try to put in incentives and milestones that will help individuals be able to rise above that learning curve and be able to start their business.
Okay.
So those are the things that we focus on. We have incentives in our program, extra training through mentorship in our program.
Mm-hmm.
And we're also building a entrepreneur's fund.
All right.
That is designed to give seed money to individuals to help them lay the foundation for their business. And that foundation, of course, is getting legal with the state of Ohio, being able to get your marketing pieces together so that you can attract customers and other things related to that. And so we're putting together the Entrepreneurs Fund, which is more of a pay it forward piece. Donors give into the fund.
Okay.
And then we give the grant. In essence, to the person, and then the person has a certain period of time, and it's not just 2 months.
Okay,
they have a nice long period of time to pay that back. And there's no interest.
Okay, awesome.
There's nothing in reference to that. But the reason why we ask you to give that back is so that we can have it to help another
That's I like it. So they are in a sense paying it for it.
Exactly. So those are just a few of the things that we add to our coaching program to really help people be able to build their business.
Okay.
And for Collaboration Station, it's all about if you look good, we look good.
Absolutely.
So we want to make sure that you get that education.
Okay.
And it's very important to us to give people the knowledge. If you have the knowledge, you can make the decision.
Okay.
We've had people who've come to us initially talking about a business, and at the end of the day, they decided, you know what? Entrepreneurship's not really for me. I'd rather go out and get a job and then retire and be okay. I don't think I'm going to do all that.
It's a very challenging role, but it's also very rewarding.
Absolutely.
I wouldn't trade it for anything.
Absolutely.
Yes.
And most of our people, they share that same thought process with you.
Okay.
This will be rewarding in whatever vein.
Yes.
And everybody's not trying to be Donald Trump.
That's right.
You know, but whatever I can do to help support myself and help support my community, I can put into that. I'm building something.
Yes, absolutely.
And that is very important to just pretty much all of the people that we serve. And we take the time and hold their hands and encourage them as well as educate them way that enables them to help themselves.
Okay.
And that is what's most important about our work. And that's what makes our work nonprofit.
Absolutely. Yes, absolutely. We're going to hear more. We'll come right back.
Satan is attacking your praise because he knows if he can silence you, he can keep you from being free. Your praise is a weapon, and it's time to fight back. The purpose of praise is not necessarily a deep subject. God created us for his glory, and he desires for us to do just that, give him glory. This is the primary function of praise. Beloved, if you are hurting and wearing a mask, you won't move anywhere in the spirit until you release the hurt. When you release the hurt, God will release you. You must be real enough and truthful enough with yourself to acknowledge that you need God to help you get through this.
Back again with Cheryl Smith, founding CEO of Collaboration Station. And Cheryl, we left off on your own. You're just giving us an overview and telling us about your program. You mentioned something in there about working with one-on-one and then creating a strategy. Now, once that strategy is created, you or your staff, do you actually walk that entrepreneur through that strategy, step by step until you throw them out the nest, so to speak, until they can fly? Okay.
Absolutely. Definitely. We do that. Most of the time when individuals come to us, there are a couple of tools that we use. There is an assessment tool which is just kind of giving people or understanding what people already know about starting a business. People come in at various different levels.
Yes.
And sometimes there are some people who have started a business before, but it didn't go the way they had planned, and so they're coming back to learn what they didn't know.
Okay. All right.
And for some people, it's a brand new venture. And for some folks, they've been burned before. They've talked to other people, they've been burned, and now they want to figure out, okay, I still have this passion, I still have this dream, can I trust you with my dream?
Yes,
and we rebuild them at that point. So all of that is a part of assessment, and then what we call progress notes. So we always make a note of what's your progress. And everyone comes away with the homework assignment, their milestones, and then each the coaching process takes them through whatever that goal setting piece is. Because after the assessment, we set some goals, and then the goal, the whole coaching process is around reaching those goals.
Okay.
And sometimes life happens. Life happens, and I have to put a halt on my goal for a quick minute.
Okay.
And that's quite all right.
Okay.
If you have to put a halt on it, we understand. We don't have an attitude about it. Life happens.
Yes, it does. Yes,
and
it does.
And then once you are ready to come back, then you come on back and we pick up like you never left.
All right. That's
so
exciting.
There's all kinds of forgiveness with that as well.
Yes.
Because we really want people to, first of all, understand and know that, you know, your dreams are important.
Yes.
And we want you to be able to fulfill that if you want to.
Mm-hmm.
And then we want people to know that there is help out there.
Yes.
We're not the only agency that helps people,
mm-hmm.
but we are very concerned about your success. A lot of times in society, people feel like everyone is just out for themselves and a lot of ego, especially in business, which can be brutal sometimes.
Yes, it can.
But no, you do have, there is a company out there that is concerned about your success as an entrepreneur and as a business person, and that company is Collaboration Station.
Absolutely. And I just want to add, too, here before we take another break, that I had met you at one of your events. It was the faith-based conference. Was it back in, you know, the end of
November?
Yes, it was November, and I was very impressed. And, you know, how that was organized, how it was put together,
Thank you.
The vendors, the panel that you had put together, and your main speakers, and the people there in the audience, if you were able to you know, to ask questions right there, you know, from the panel, from the speakers, and it was very interactive, and I thought that was very important to be able. To engage in the seminar or the workshop instead of just being talked to, you know, you have materials, you can buy my book or my tapes or whatever, and maybe I'll have time for a few questions, but people, we had time for people to really formulate questions, and sometimes, you know, when one question is asked, another one, you know, comes, it's an errand, it's kind of born out of that current question. So it was very, very good. I just wanted to commend you on that event.
Thank you. And look forward to being able to
support you and to find out, you know, other things that you may have coming up down the road.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. We are, with the faith-based event, we're looking at doing the next one in 2013. We're hoping to secure some sponsors at the end of 2012 for corporations.
Mm-hmm.
Put their budgets together if any corporations are listening.
Okay. It's an awesome investment.
Awesome.
Very worthy.
Yes. And so we're hoping to do it in 2013. And one of the things that we focus on with the faith-based conference, a lot of times the reason why it is because a lot of times people assume that people of faith are so focused on their faith that they're not paying attention to the business side and the administrative side of what they're embarking upon, whether it's writing a book, doing a business, being a social worker, even their ministry.
Yes.
And people of faith do want to know more about what is that business side of what I'm doing to make sure that I'm not only doing it well on my faith, but I'm also doing it well in the business world as well.
Yes.
And so that's the whole premise behind the faith-based conference.
Mm-hmm.
And so we wanted to make it an environment where people can interact, can talk.
Okay.
Because how are you going to get the knowledge if you don't get to ask the question?
That's right.
Okay.
That's right.
So it's very important that we create that kind of atmosphere so that people can feel comfortable sharing their questions. No question is a dumb question.
Yes.
No question is.
Yes. That's right.
And then also have access to resources that they can then tap into later, mm-hmm. after the conference. And it's not intimidating. It's not,
absolutely.
Oh my goodness, are they going to understand the passion that I have, mm-hmm. for this from a faith perspective? Well, these people do, because they're, mm-hmm. all people of faith.
That's right.
But they're also very successful in working in the world and doing business,
yes.
with the world. And so we wanted to bring those two facets together, and we're, mm-hmm. going to be doing more of those conferences. One of the things that we're planning on adding to it,
okay.
is helping individuals who might be interested in getting into the ebook arena.
Oh yes,
there's
absolutely.
A lot of authors and,
mm-hmm.
and publishers and those who are interested in seeing their works on Kindle and,
mm-hmm.
and on Nook and those kinds of things, and understand, how do I make that happen? If I'm,
yes.
self-publishing, how do I make that happen?
Yes. Yes.
So we're going to add that entire education piece to the faith-based business mini conferences.
Okay.
So
all
that's
right.
one thing that people can look forward to,
great,
in
great.
The new conference schedule.
Okay. In the meantime, where can we get in touch with Collaboration Station?
Well, we can get you. People can get in touch with us in a couple,
mm-hmm.
different ways.
All right.
Definitely through our website, which,
okay.
is www.collabstation,
right.
that's collabstation.org.
Mm-hmm.
People can also get in touch with us through our general email box, which is checked on a weekly basis. We do check that on a weekly basis, which is admin@collabstation.org. Or
great.
Phone calls are great. You can call 216-704-9806 or 234-738-3054.
That's awesome. That's hopefully we'll get some people ringing those phones and blowing up your email box. Absolutely, you have some awesome things that you're offering. We're going to be right back after this message.
Imagine having 16 people located anywhere in the world on a live video conference at the same time. That is the power of My Video Boardroom. This is an exciting product because within the boardroom, you can do presentations, PowerPoints, share your desktop, and so many more features. Include up to 16 video participants. Chat. No reservations required. Toll or toll-free numbers. Up to 100 attendees via phone. VoIP audio. Application sharing and desktop collaboration. The only person that needs the My Video Talk account on this conference is you, the person that schedules the meeting. Everyone else just needs internet access and a simple webcam to be part of the action. With our unique setup wizard, you can be up and running in minutes. Imagine how this product could cut down on travel time and expenses for businesses all over the world. My Video Boardroom, available exclusively through My Video Talk.
With Cheryl Smith from Collaboration Station. Ms. Cheryl, you gave us a lot of information today and the different programs that you're offering. Very commendable. Seems
Thank
like
you.
Very valuable courses and workshops for individuals and groups to be able to plug into. Now, you talked earlier about non-traditional populations that you serve, but there's another area of folks that that have business ideas, they're very creative, they're brilliant, but they maybe lack income.
Mm-hmm.
To do things, or maybe they think that they can't. So
yeah.
Speak to this group of people.
Well, definitely. One
mm-hmm.
of the focuses of our business, and it's the heart of what Collaboration Station does as a nonprofit,
mm-hmm.
is work with low-income populations,
okay.
who are interested in starting their own business,
mm-hmm.
whether it be nonprofit or for-profit.
All right.
Low-income for us can mean poverty level,
mm-hmm.
just above poverty level.
All right.
200% below poverty level.
The working poor.
The working poor, the suburban poor, and anybody who is on public assistance.
Okay.
Okay.
Awesome.
And what is very interesting, we have found in mm-hmm. our work, and the research attests to this, that 38% of all not nonprofit, 38% mm-hmm. of all small businesses
all right.
come from low-income individuals.
Wow.
National research in the U.S. And then on top of that, 8%
mm-hmm.
of those individuals who start businesses and add to GDP are living at or below poverty level. So these,
that's interesting.
It is very interesting. And so these are people who pay their taxes. They,
mm-hmm.
you know, because we couldn't count them.
Exactly.
They weren't paying.
Exactly.
Okay.
That's right. That's right.
So, you know, there's a lot of stereotypes and stigmas out there around
mm-hmm.
low-income people. And why would you want to spend this much time, this much effort
mm-hmm.
in trying to help low-income folks or folks on public benefits to start their own businesses?
Yes.
Well, it's very significant to
mm-hmm.
the local economy.
That's right.
If there are 8% of them who are low, who are below poverty level, and 38%
mm-hmm.
nationally who start businesses who are low-income, that's a significant amount of money.
That's correct.
And
yes.
that's a significant number of jobs.
Mm-hmm.
And the Small Business Administration has already said that 52% of all jobs
mm-hmm.
created in the U.S. are created through small businesses.
That's fascinating.
So the small business piece of this, and particularly
mm-hmm.
for low-income individuals, is huge. If we can harness that, and harness that power, and
mm-hmm.
harness what they have going for them, in the area of entrepreneurship, we can really make a difference in our local economies.
Yes.
And so that's why we focus on that population.
Mm-hmm.
And yes, there is a little bit more required. Okay.
Okay.
Because the learning curve can be a little bit higher.
Mm-hmm.
But that's okay. I mean,
that's
no
right.
one should think that
mm-hmm.
they cannot do it for whatever reason educationally.
That's right.
It's just a matter of how you are taught.
Mm-hmm.
And
okay.
what we focus on is teaching people and reaching them where they are.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why low-income entrepreneurs come to us
okay.
who are interested in starting their own for-profit business.
Mm-hmm.
We really try to work with the paradigm that the person is in. And one of the things that we really stress is making sure that low-income populations know that there is no success overnight.
Yes.
When you're talking about entrepreneurship.
Mm-hmm.
It is a steady process that you must go through.
Yes.
And there are certain I's that have to be dotted
mm-hmm.
and T's that have to be crossed.
Right.
but in addition to that, you also need a support system.
Yes.
You can't grow your business being on public assistance and
mm-hmm.
not have a support system that's going to make sure you eat every day.
That's right.
Because starting that business is not where all your eating is going to come from when you get started. Let me just say.
I know. Trust me.
So, as long as we reinforce those concepts
mm-hmm.
and bring in the teaching from where they're at,
yes.
and not try to be above board, for lack of a better word, really being able to reach people where they are is very important
mm-hmm.
because that's where the success will come in. And it's very important for us to make sure that we, when we're working with low-income populations,
okay.
can relate to what they're talking to.
Okay.
You know, so because if we can't relate to what they're saying, we won't be able to help them as effectively.
Okay, so
as
you have someone who's been on low-income person,
absolutely.
Has their business, and now they're teaching, you know, lending.
Absolutely.
Yes.
I'm low-income.
Mm-hmm.
I understand what it means to,
yes.
you know, try to start a business and then
mm-hmm.
trying to figure out which bills you're going to pay,
mm-hmm.
and then your electric is off for 2 months because you didn't make enough money.
Right.
I've been there
okay.
and done that.
Yes.
So
yes,
I can
too.
Certainly understand that conversation.
Yes.
And there's a lot of wonderful ideas that people have. So
mm-hmm.
some of the ideas that some of the business folks have come, low income as well as others,
mm-hmm.
they have wanted to do rehab houses, so
okay.
sober houses.
Yes.
For individuals, they have wanted to, I have one young lady that wants to sell shoes for specializing in women who have sizes 10 and up.
All right.
I have one client that has turned the foreclosure market
mm-hmm.
to his benefit, and he actually takes property pictures
mm-hmm.
for banks to make
okay.
sure that the property is not vandalized,
mm-hmm.
and they pay him per picture.
Okay.
I have another client who started a t-shirt business,
mm-hmm.
and he's starting his own t-shirt line out of that business.
Wow.
And the information in terms of the types of shirts that he gets, mm-hmm. very quality. We're
okay.
talking Hanes. It's the same
yes.
kind of stuff that you would buy
mm-hmm.
in Walmart or JCPenney.
Okay.
And all these individuals are in have that ingenuity themselves because
mm-hmm.
they went out and figured out where their distributors are.
Okay.
They found out what their process needed to be. They figured out what their markup needs to be.
Mm-hmm.
So it's, you know, it can be done. It doesn't matter what your
yes.
income level is. As long as you have that tenacity, that perseverance.
They took the word out of my mouth.
Absolutely. And you're willing to do the work.
Yeah.
You can do it. You can
mm-hmm.
do it. And so we stress that at Collaboration Station with every
mm-hmm.
client that we serve. And we have seen them become successful themselves. We have a client who started an agency to help ex-offenders get employment
okay.
opportunities. So there are lots of different wonderful ideas. I have one
mm-hmm.
client that's starting to try to do her internet marketing business.
All right.
So it's wonderful the
mm-hmm.
opportunities
yes.
that people say see that they could
mm-hmm.
potentially tap into.
Okay.
So it just needs a little bit more coaching to get
mm-hmm.
it done.
Absolutely. Now, how does it work, say, for the person who's on public assistance?
Mm-hmm.
And because I know, you know, have dealt with people in different times where they're on public assistance, they get a job, and then they, you know, so the income is constantly doing like this. So
mm-hmm.
if you get more hours, you know, then it's less money coming in your check, or
mm-hmm.
gets to a certain point where they get cut off of that
mm-hmm.
public assistance, whether it's the check and food stamps or,
mm-hmm.
you know, just the food supplement.
Mm-hmm.
How does that work as far as helping them to bridge that gap?
It is a very interesting dance, and
okay.
it is going to depend on what public assistance they might be on and
okay.
what they're getting and what they're not getting.
Mm-hmm.
But essentially, what we do is we have to look at their threshold. And every
All
person
right.
knows what their threshold is for their benefits.
Mm-hmm.
We are starting to get some veterans now as
okay.
well, and people on disability. And
mm-hmm.
so we definitely look at what they are allowed to make, what they're not allowed to make.
Okay.
And then on top of that, what we do is there's a lot of planning involved.
Mm-hmm.
One of the things that we encourage them not to do is don't start trying to do sales, for example,
okay.
of any product before you know how this is going to affect the income
mm-hmm.
in your household. Okay, it's very important that they not do that because we don't want them to not do what they're supposed to do
right.
in reference to their public benefits. So
mm-hmm.
it's a very delicate dance.
Okay.
And one of the wonderful things that we were able to do is people look at how much what their threshold is for making funds. And this year, we had several people who started their own businesses. And of course, they had never filled out a Schedule C.
Oh, yeah.
And so we had a lot of calls
mm-hmm.
in February saying, oh, my goodness, Michelle, what am I going to do? What am I going to do? I made a little bit of money. And I know I didn't mess up my benefits, but now I got to claim that. What am I supposed to do?
Yeah.
And so we had one of the accountants who works with us, James Oliver,
okay.
From JC and Associates, come in
mm-hmm.
and actually have a 2.5-hour session.
Wow.
On, okay, now since you've made this little bit of money, this is how it's accounted for. This is
mm-hmm.
how it's recorded. This is what you needed to make sure that you put together in your receipts. And I think he got a couple clients out of that too.
Okay. Good for you.
But in that way, we make sure that people do not find themselves
mm-hmm.
getting disqualified for their public benefits because they made too much money in their business.
Yeah.
Is we monitor that
mm-hmm.
and the person monitors that.
Okay.
Very closely.
All right.
Because we don't want them to get themselves out of their benefits before they can come all the way out and
mm-hmm.
be able to support themselves.
Absolutely. That's awesome.
Mm-hmm.
That's fantastic. We're going to take one more break, Cheryl. We're going to come back, and I want you to give us some advice or, you know, just close us out and, you know, again, how we can get in touch with you.
Okay.
Okay, we'll be right back.
Did you know that your opinion matters? Did you know that your vote really counts? Well, it does, at least as soon as you apply this right. But what's a right anyway if you never use it? It's yours and nobody can take it from you, right? Wrong. By not having what you need in order to vote, you allow this right to be taken away, which is un-American, unjust, and unfair. Take a stand. Go to www.project5millionvoterid.com. Place your mark in the history today.
This is your day to shine, your time to win, so raise your cup and drink.
Hii coffee ni nzuri sana, kwa hivyo tunatakikana kukunywa, alafu tunasaidia dunia yote. trayendo los tesoros de la tierra a la gente del mundo.
We're back now with Cheryl Smith of Collaboration Station. Cheryl, you've given us some awesome information today. I'm excited to hear about the different populations, the non-traditional, like non-traditional students going back to college, and in this case of owning their own business or nonprofit. So tell us a little bit more, what advice that you would have for us, and if there's anything that I didn't cover question-wise, please share with us now in this last 5 minutes.
Okay. Well, in essence, it's very important. We want folks to understand that the population that we serve that's low income really needs additional support.
Okay.
You know, a lot of times people think that, all they want to do, they're lazy, they just want to live on public benefits, but that's not the case, particularly with the individuals that we serve.
Mm-hmm.
It's just difficult to come out of that cycle of dependence.
Yes.
And so this is a serious need because there are many people who do want to rise above that and support themselves.
Mm-hmm.
But we need your support to make that happen.
All right, and how can we do that?
Well, it would be great if we could receive your tax-deductible contribution.
Okay, awesome.
Collaboration Station.
Okay.
Every dollar that we receive in tax deductible contributions goes towards the operation of the program.
Okay.
And a portion of those proceeds also go towards the entrepreneurship fund.
Yes, right. We wanted to hear more about the entrepreneur fund. That was an awesome concept.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Well, the entrepreneurship fund really came out of a conversation that we had with our first donor to that fund, who his focus was wanting to assist individuals who were coming out and reentering society.
Okay.
And he prefers to remain anonymous.
That's fine. A lot of donors do
that.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Yes.
And so the thought process is that, particularly when you're talking about a low-income entrepreneur or even a single person for whom single people, the tax liability is the largest of anyone, that doesn't have enough disposable income to be able to make this advanced step to advance their life through entrepreneurship.
Okay.
Can we help them in any way financially? They don't necessarily have the best credit. They're definitely not, don't have the best credit score, or they may not have any credit at all.
Okay.
And so the purpose of the Entrepreneurs Fund is to provide that little bit of seed money to an individual and not put a whole lot of restrictions on that funding.
Okay.
In terms of the loan process and percentages of when you have to pay it back. But at the same time, show a person the importance of paying it forward.
Yes.
And so the Entrepreneurs Fund is a donor-sponsored fund. We ask for donations from individuals, $20, $10, $25.
Yes.
$100 goes a long way to helping the person make sure their business is legal.
Okay.
And then also to help them get the marketing materials they need to be able to make their business as successful and get that word out to their community so that they can begin to make money.
Okay.
And a lot of that is covered through the Entrepreneurship Fund, because the one thing that you tend not to be able to get money for, grant money for, is the actual legalization and putting all the birds together and all the ducks in a row.
Yes.
So that's the whole focus of the Entrepreneurs Fund. And so it's great if we could have additional donors to actually help these other low-income populations through that fund.
All right.
And then we make the donor accountable, not the donor, but the individual receiving fund accountable for keeping the fund alive.
Okay. All right. I like that. I like this. It's recycling that dollar back in that type of community.
Exactly.
You know, right there. Entrepreneurs. Yeah, that's fantastic. For sure, that's all the time we have today.
It's
awesome that you came by and spent
so
some time
much.
With us. Appreciate it. Look forward to hearing more about what you're doing, your different events and business adventures and the success stories coming out of Collaboration Station.
Absolutely.
Okay,
absolutely.
So you take care, and
thank
God bless you. I look forward to seeing you again soon.
Thank you.
Okay,
thank
and for you out there, you go out and make something positive happen for you in your world. If you want to start a business or nonprofit, please definitely check with Collaboration Station, collabstation.org.
Yes.
Collabstation.org, and you'll see the information is down here on your screen and also in the credits. Take care.